Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu vows to continue fighting Gaza militants, even after U.S. President Joe Biden urged him to de-escalate the tensions. Netanyahu says operations in Gaza will continue until they restore security for the people of Israel. Meantime, an Egyptian security source says, while the two sides have agreed in principle to a ceasefire, the details are still secretly being negotiated. Earlier this week, a senior Hamas official said he expects Israel and Gaza's militants to reach a ceasefire within the next 2 days. More than 200 people have died in Gaza due to airstrikes, including dozens of children, while the death toll in Israel stands at 12. The Philippines halts the deployment of migrant workers to Israel as the cross-border attacks between Israelis and Palestinians enter its 11th day. The Labor Department says while the government will continue to process jab applications of workers, there will be no deployments. This includes the 400 Filipino caregivers set to depart as part of a bilateral agreement with Israel. The agency has also deployed its rapid response team to prepare for possible repatriation of Filipinos.
Hindi po na ngayon, hindi po na. At makikipag-consult na rin ako kay Secretary Locking tungkol sa alert level doon. Lagi na, kikita naman natin, putukan dito, putukan doon. Mahirap na pagka mag-deploy tayo, mamaya may nangyari.
Opo.
Malaki pa na nagkutang ko po. Hanggat hindi natin natitiyak ang kanilang
kaligtasan.
Kaligtasan, Joy. So,
kasi tuloy-tuloy pa rin bombahan. Okay.
At wala nang bombahan, at sabi ng Department of Foreign Affairs natin na okay na.
There are around 30,000 Filipino workers in Israel, most of whom are domestic helpers.